Here we are back with fundamentals of universal numbers, and we will see two more important fundamentals derived from basic fundamentals. So here we will discuss the negative number line and a subtraction operation. Just like real number lines with a common center 0 have the same magnitude on both sides, in a similar fashion we have also a universal number line with extended numbers on real number line. So, 0 is also part of the number line, which is both positive and negative, with its multiplicative inverse as positive and negative infinity respectively. And here, the connecting point is 0 square, but connecting point can be any magnitude, 0 cube too. And an equation ends up to the solution at the center point, it has two solutions, positive and negative 0, or 0 square or 0 cube. But positive magnitude is the principal solution. Some more detail you will get from the first fundamental video as we have discussed this point. And these are some subtraction examples to consider. So this is how generally the subtraction is done, which in detail is discussed in the first fundamental video. And it is termed as natural subtraction. In short, subtraction. But there is also another subtraction rule that is introduced for multiple reasons, and that is not other than the subtraction formula from the real number system, n minus n is equal to 0. And this is termed as supernatural subtraction or super subtraction. Generally this breaks the rules of universal numbers, but it also has some convenience in mathematical operation. So it is used for certain application where it does not break the rules of universal number system. There are two common applications: to eliminate the magnitude completely out of the equation, and to indicate the previous number or number shifts. And super subtraction is indicated by the bar on top of the subtracting magnitude. And since n minus n is equal to 0, everyone knows it. Now coming to first case, to eliminate the magnitude completely out of the equation, let's consider the equation 10 is equal to 10. And if we add minus 3 on both the side of equation, solution will be 7 plus 3 times 0 is equal to 7 plus 3 times 0, if we do the subtraction. But if you add minus 3 as a super subtraction on both sides, then it will be 7 is equal to 7. And note that both of these equations are balanced but completely different. However, it comes with restriction that when we use at this level, the subtraction operation is balanced as per universal number system. But with the same rules, this equation is open to perform addition or subtraction operation, but locked to perform rest all other arithmetic operations such as multiplication, division, power. As absence of this magnitude in this equation will unbalance the equation, or presence of this uncompleted subtraction will create unbalance if you do mention operation with y, unless this is gone. Generally, super subtraction should be used to eliminate the magnitude on both the sides completely before undergoing any other operation, and everything will be easy. The second use case is to indicate previous numbers or number shifts. There are equations in real numbers that are constructed in certain logic such that n-1 indicates the previous number, or n-x indicates the shift of magnitude by x. So such cases, super subtraction should be used to clearly distinguish the outcome of the operation. For example, n times n-1 factorial. The expected operation is 5 times 5-1, 4-1, 3-1, 2-1, 1-1 factorial, which should work like this, and not this operation. So these are the two situations where supernatural subtractions are used, and now we'll also be able to understand this pop-up video more effectively. And it is a formula for negative integers which don't exist in real numbers. Happy journey.